A number of people have called the county extension offices asking about the lack of sightings of songbirds in recent days. And there is some merit to those questions that we have. There are some declining songbirds in Arkansas because of the habitat destruction, not only from construction and development, but also even from natural causes, such as the weather or from insect invasions that we've had in Arkansas here periodically. The mockingbird is pretty much in a stable situation from the data that we've collected and what we can tell. There's a couple other birds like the American robin that we get questions about them periodically, but according to the information we have, their populations appear stable as well. Then there's some other birds that are actually increasing in Arkansas. And some of those species include the American goldfinch, which you see a lot around your bird feeders. And you know, that's a bird that lots of people like to see, but then there's also other species maybe that we're not too keen about. Maybe the American crow is another species that tends to be on the increase. So, and then there's some species that are on the decrease, like the house sparrow, which nobody really likes the house sparrow too much. And so, you know, it's even though there are some species that are declining, it's a mixed bag, really. Some of the beneficial things that Arkansas homeowners can do is putting shrubs, more shrubbery in their lawns and creating more of that kind of brushy habitat for some of our birds that need that the shrubbery in order to nest. So we could do a better job at providing that. In Arkansas, there's a state organization. It's the Arkansas State Wildlife Action Plan, in which over 300 Arkansas species of concern have been identified. And many of those are songbirds that are species of concern. And so these partners are getting together, looking at habitat, looking at the habitat needs, looking at education, public education that needs to be conducted. And at some point, we're going to get to the stage where we're going to implement some of these practices, and we're going to need landowners' help. There's no way we're going to be successful unless we have the public on our side and with us, and the landowners putting this habitat on the ground for our wildlife species.
To learn more, contact your county extension agent and follow the links in this section.